In today's session, we are going to discuss on a topic, advanced instrument. In that, we focus on theodolite. Myself, Bipin Patil, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. These are the learning outcomes for today's session. So at the end of this particular session, learners, students will be able to explain about theodolite, concept of theodolite, its working principle and function. First thing, what is theodolite? Observe these pictures, the digital theodolite, vernier theodolite, different front elevation is present here, captured view, side elevation, telescope is present here, vertical disc, horizontal disc, linear micro screws are present here, bubble tube. So what do you mean by theodolite? Basically these two instruments, first one, an instrument which is used in surveying to measure horizontal vertical angles with a small telescope, that can move in the horizontal and vertical planes. So you just observe this picture, it moves in a horizontal direction, it moves in a vertical direction. So easily you can identify the vertical angles, also horizontal angles. Similarly for this digital theodolite, this is nothing but your vernier theodolite, this is digital theodolite. Theodolites are an electronic device, not regarding this instrument, are widely used for the measurement of vertical and horizontal angles. The purpose is same regarding these two instruments. Here we are identifying the angles, vertical, horizontal, here also same. Now here we are using the vernier readings, and here we are using the digital readings. So these particular instruments are used in the construction industry to identify the angles. What do you mean by theodolite surveying? By using this instrument, whatever the surveying work is carried out, we called as theodolite surveying. A system of surveying in which the angles are measured with the help of theodolite. These particular angles are measured, vertical angle, horizontal angle, with the help of theodolite, is called as theodolite surveying. Two pictures are continuously I'm using for next slides also. Uses of theodolite. Basically, why you are using theodolite? First one, measuring horizontal and vertical angle. So for digital theodolite, we require some input data, including climates also. And here you have to fix the horizontal and vertical linear vernier readings. And according to that, vertical disc and horizontal disc uses use to identify the angles. Second one, locating points on a line. We are using theodolite. Third one, prolonging the survey lines for route survey work, for canal work, then for railway track preparing to identify the survey line. To prolong the survey lines, we are using theodolites. Finding the difference of levels, we are using such types of theodolites. In curves, theodolite plays a vital role, ranging curves, to prepare a curve, different types of curves are present. So in such cases, we are using theodolite very widely. And each and all tachometric survey work based on this theodolite. In tachometric survey work, we are considering the constants. So see here, basically to identify the angles, to identify the distances, to prolonging the survey work, to identify the straight line path, to identify the bearings with respect to north direction, we are using this particular theodolite. Next one, classification of theodolite. Theodolite may be classified as, basically two parts are present. One is your transit theodolite and non-transit theodolite. We'll discuss in detail. And second one, vernier theodolite and micrometer theodolites are there. What do you mean by transit theodolite? See here. A theodolite is called transit theodolite when, so same theodolite is present here, when its telescope can be transited. A telescope can be transited, that is revolved through a complete revolution. Through a complete, it may be vertical, it may be horizontal. Revolved through a complete revolution about its horizontal axis. Horizontal fundamental axis are present. In the vertical plane, we called as transit theodolite. And similarly, non-transit theodolite means the telescope cannot be transited. Here, the telescope is transited and revolved through a complete revolution about the horizontal axis in the vertical plane. And here, it cannot transit it. So, transit theodolite, non-transit theodolite. Vernier theodolite. We are using vernier in that. For reading the graduated circle, if verniers are used in a theodolite, we call it as vernier theodolite. And instead of that, if I put micrometer to identify these particular readings, we call it as micrometer theodolite. If a micrometer is provided to read the graduated circle, the same we called as micrometer theodolite is there. Nowadays, basically, vernier type of theodolites are commonly used to identify the angles, to identify the distances and remaining some survey works. Basically, the adjustment of theodolite is done by two ways. First one, permanent adjustment. Second one, temporary adjustment. We'll discuss in detail. Permanent adjustments. The permanent adjustments are made to establish the relationship between the fundamental lines of the theodolite. Now, as I mentioned here, this is your tripod. Horizontal disc is present here on a horizontal plane. Vertical plane, vertical disc, telescope, eyepiece, object glass, vernier adjustable screws. This is your dry batch. Bubble tubes are present here. So now these are the axes are present. These axes, then the vertical axis, horizontal plane, some relationships are present. Adjustment of a horizontal plate levels. First one, that is the horizontal plate level, you have to adjust. The axis of the plate levels, so it may be horizontal axis, vertical axis, must be perpendicular to the vertical axis, means horizontal axis or the axis of the plate. Suppose if I consider horizontal plane, so the axis of this particular plate must be perpendicular to the vertical axis, means vertical axis. Collimation adjustment. The line of collimation should coincide with the axis of the telescope. So line of collimation, it is present here, should coincide with the axis of telescope. Axis of telescope now present here. So axis of telescope should coincide with line of collimation, and the axis of the object or objective slide should be right angle to the horizontal axis. Next one, horizontal axis adjustment. Your horizontal axis must be perpendicular to the vertical axis. So what is the vertical axis is present here? It's perpendicular to the horizontal axis and vice versa. Next one, the adjustment of telescope level, or we called as altitude level plate levels. Adjustment of the altitude level plate level. So the axis of telescope. So observe here, the axis of the telescope levels or the altitude level must be parallel to the line of collimation. The axis of the telescope level or altitude level must be parallel to the line of collimation. And last one, that is the vertical circle index adjustment. The vertical circle vernier, in this particular vertical circle, whatever the vernier is present, that vernier must read zero when the line of collimation is horizontal. When the line of collimation is horizontal, so in that case, the vertical circle vernier must read 0. These are nothing but your permanent adjustment of theodolite. Now, the temporary adjustment of your theodolite. Basically, for any type of work, this temporary adjustment is essential. So the temporary adjustment are made at each setup of the instrument. Before we start taking observations with the instrument. So primary 3 points are present here. First one is the centering, next one the leveling, and last one the focusing. First, tripod, you have to set it. Then mount this particular instrument over the tripod and carry out the centering process. So in your centering process, you just observe, you just use the plumb bob and try to identify the centering. Otherwise, use this particular object glass is present here and observe your centering point, that is on the present on a ground level. After the centering process is over, you move towards leveling. Plate level is present here, foot screws are present. Slightly use two foot screws and try to bring this plate level or bubble tube exactly at a central position. Or easily can carry out the leveling process. After that, use eyepiece, object glass, and try to adjust the parallax. So this process is nothing but the focusing. So my now dear friends, you just try to pause the video. Try to give the answer of this particular question. And the answer of this particular question. To prepare this particular session, I refer these were the references. Thank you.